Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the series of the Machine Learning and MLOps in Databricks. I will explain you how to work with secrets, the key containers in the Databricks workspace, and how to integrate this with the, in this case, with the technology Azure Keyboard. We are working in Azure in this case. It's possible to do this as well with in AWS, but today we will do it with Azure. In another video, we will integrate this with the keyboard in AWS. I have prepared a notebook, as usual, a couple of notebooks on how to do this. Essentially, what you need to know to start is how you can create secrets. First of all, what are secrets? Secrets is essentially a vault to keep your secrets and your API keys, your URLs with sensible data secure. They are designed to work inside the Databricks workspace, so this is the secrets are working in any Databricks workspace. When I say any, is you, as you probably know, you had the Databricks in Amazon, in Google, or in Azure. So this, what you are gonna see here, is exactly the same regardless the cloud provider. The only thing here that we are gonna do that is specific is the integration with the key vault. The key vault is the vault container service in Azure. So this part is specific for Azure, but the other one is this stat that we will see at the beginning is useful and the same for the three main cloud providers. So secondly, how you can create secrets, and you can create it using three different ways, no? One is using the CLI. We will look in your local environment. You have to have installed and configured the Databricks CLI, and once you have it, you can work with the, you can create, you can list, you can update any secret that you had in the container. The containers here have the name of the scope. The scope is a vault itself. You can have as many as you want, and you can introduce on that key vaults as much as you want keys or values, sensible information that you need to use and to share in your workspace. Okay, so this is one of the options. The second option is the one that we will see in detail, is using the API version 2, the RESTful API that comes with Databricks. In both cases, you are going to need the Databricks host and the Databricks token. Databricks host, as you probably know, is this part of the URL of your workspace, and the token is the one that you generate here in settings. Developer tokens. You had videos on the channel on how to create the tokens, so we will not cover this today. And the third option is using the shell of your computer cluster. So when you go to your computer cluster, you go to apps, and you have here the web terminal. Probably if you didn't activate it, you will not have you will have this grid. So you need to go again to settings. Let's go in this other stream. Settings, compute, and here web terminal activated here. Okay. So this page is obviously old. And then once you have it activated, you have the, you can click the button and you get access to a cell, which essentially is connects you to the driver of your Databricks cluster. And then here you can execute Databricks, and this is the CLI that you have installed in your Databricks cluster. You need to configure exactly the same that you do with the Databricks CLI. And also, if you need to do it, you have videos on the channel in how to do this. No? So, using the API, first of all, well, let me show you. When you have this, there is Databricks secrets, a secrets command in Databricks, and you can simply list scope or just simply get here secrets, and you get all the available commands that you have with secrets. Again, you need to configure with Databricks configure the CLI. It doesn't matter if you do it here or you do it in the command line, and after that you can work with the CLI without any problem. You can compare here, the options we had are practically the same, so, and this is everything that you can do with secrets. Secrets, well, you have here a description, whatever, yeah, it's what I told you, everything that you need to connect to databases, data lakes, service principal accounts, Hugging Face tokens, like you will see here, all of this stuff in order to keep it confidential and not accessible to anybody, just to protect it, because somebody can take advantage of your services, create a big invoice that you will need to pay, or simply hack your systems. Better to have all this stuff and security common practice and in general a good practice not to expose your secrets to anybody. So this is all the stuff that you can do. So not this. So when you usually get list is done with a get, a request get. When you need to write a secret, for example, usually you use post. You have the description of the values that you need, and now we are going to see some examples. As I said, you need like in configure, you need the host and the token, all the requests, regardless if the request is a get or a post, need to be authenticated with the token. You need to create some headers, and these headers attach it to the request. Here, to create an scope, you just simply compose the URL with your workspace URL plus the URL of the service that you want to use. In this case, is create an scope, and then you just simply go here, create a scope, and then you just copy this and compose the final URL. You create your body, you can take a look what do you really need. Scope, initial management principal, this is only for Azure Key Vault. By default it will be used Databricks backend. Databricks backend means that is only used inside your Databricks workspace. If you use Azure Key Vault, you will be integrating this, or you will be using the Key Vault as a secret container. And then this is the stuff that we will see at the end. So you want to create it, you just provide a name and scope backend type, and that's it. You just make a post, URL, the headers and the data in JSON format. And you get a 200. Here we create three. Let's do a three. And yeah, we got it. If you want to list the scopes you have, list of scopes, exactly, Because this is not the list of secrets. We use the same, we have our URL, the headers, and in this case we use this entry point. You just give it, and you can see here we had the new one that we just created seconds ago. You have it here available. This is let's say this is the shape box, okay, that you have created, and inside this shape box you can introduce keys or sensible information. Then on we have ACLs, access control lists, is the term, the abbreviature of this term. What is this? Essentially you get access to manage, create secrets, or even list the secrets or scope in your workspace to some users. And then on by default, the owner of the workspace will get access as let's check where is this. Auto manage to the owner, and you can provide access. You can provide permissions of manage, write, or read to different users in your workspace. In my case, I only had a user, myself, so well, it's pretty simple. So you can see here, you just point to the URL, and yeah, and you get this. In case that you have other users, you can you just specify the principal and the title permission that you want to use, and that's it. Usually what you do is you provide the permission to read to anybody in your workspace, but you have to do it one by one. And then on some users have the ability to write, and maybe another one just to manage case that you are not available. How to add a secrets, this is also the similar concept, secrets put the URL, and here you just in the body choose the scope, choose the key, this is the name of the secret, and then on the string the value of the string. Let's put here another one, we are doing in tested. And then on, if you want to get a secret, you just use another URL. And then on, we are going to get the one we key to, exactly, I just updated. If you do the post into a key which is already existing, like was this case, you just update the secret. And then you can see here, you obtain a value. This value is base 64 obfuscated because it's not an encryption. Here I make a request of another scope, and then you can see here the value using the base 64 library. You can decode the secret. This you can only do it here using the API. The secrets are not exposed. You will see now in Databricks, you will never see it using the API. And finally, to list the secrets, you have here another URL where you can simply make a list of the key names, of the names of your keys, and where they were the last time that they were updated. Okay, later again I will push this notebook to the repository, and I will give you a link in the description of the video to you download and use it in your environment. Then on to use this in your workspace, you just need to use the dbutils. This is a library that works only inside Databricks workspace, and well, it's pretty similar to to what you see is you have the different scopes, and to access a secret you use just dbut secrets get scope, the name of the scope and the key that you want to access. As you can see here, when you visualize this, you try to print it, always the workspace is prepared to never ever show in a cell. This is block using how to say some logic behind, but when you when it's need in the workflow the workflow execution, the key is liberated, no, it's free up, and it can be used in your application. You can see here an example of how can be used. I think it's here, so you check here. I use it to get my Hugging Face token. Exactly, you can see here. I just get from the scope the Hugging Face token, and then on I assign it to an environment variable. This logic, when you execute it, is essentially working. You never expose the secret. What more? The latest stuff we'll see. Well, here I think it's not it's quite self-explanatory. You can update as well here with secrets. Well, with dbutils. You cannot, as you can see, you cannot write. You just can use the secret. So it's not a tool to manage. To manage, as I said, CLI, a cell in the driver of your cluster or API. There is no way to do it with dbutils. It's just dbutils is only the tool to read the secrets. Okay, and the final stuff is how to integrate this with the keyboard. The keyboard is the similar concept, or we use it for the same that we use the secrets in the workspace, but this is had a broad use. Usually is used inside the Azure to keep all the secrets that you need to work with the different services that you have in your project or in your subscription, like you can see here. It's a service that we're at subscription level, and then on here you grant access to the services that need to use and save to save or to read the keys or whatever you want to save in the vault. So what you are doing when you integrate the key vault with the secrets in the workspace is just use the key vault as a container, and then on Database has access to this container. You don't have two, you just have one, which is in this case the you can have at the same time Databricks secrets containers and also Key Vault connected to your Database workspace. You will see this now. So the first thing that you need to do is obviously having a Key Vault in your subscription, and then you need to provide access to the resource itself. This is working exactly say for any resource that you want to provide access to this key vault. So you just create, you just check here the permissions, can be key permissions, secret, certificate. For Databricks you just need secret permissions, but well, you can choose one of these templates and directly you get next. You provide here, use, look for the service Databricks, this case the provider. I already have been And then on you just hit next, review and create, and that's it. So once you have done this, this authorized the Database Workspace to use the key vault. You had to go to provide the same level of access to yourself if you want to create secrets or keys or certificates in the key vault. So use the URL, the email that you use, that's the do the same, create, and at that time when you do create, you just check here template the same, and then when you are here, you just write down the user email address that you use to access your workspace. And doing that way, later you can create a secret. You just create generate import secrets, whatever, create, and this test, you go to the test tree, you had all the versions of the secrets, and if you click here, you can simply hide the secret or copy and use it. This is also the URI of the secrets in Azure. Okay, once you have this done, the next step is going to, let me, here is secrets, I think is secrets, exactly, you have it here, secrets create scope. You just simply, after the name of the workspace, so here you have the URL, interrogant O equal the number of your workspace. You can check here is exactly the same tag here, and then you put the symbol, and then on secrets / create scope. Once you go there, you just write a name to your scope, test3 for example. You provide an access only to the creator or to all workspace users. So this is depends on your policy, to who. Essentially, you can manage later the permissions of the user. If you provide to all the users in your workspace at least read access to the secrets, you will get read access as well to the cable in Azure. So my recommendation is do it like this to later avoid doing one by one again. If you want to do it more granular, do it later one by one using the ACLs as I showed you before. Then you need two values, the DNS. DNS is you go here to your to overview, and here you have the URI, copy, paste, and you go here to JSON view, and you have here the resource ID, copy, and also paste. Once you have it, you have the this speaker 3 created, okay, and you can go again to DBUtils, and you will see here now we had another secrets scope. This is the one we just created now. All of them are pointed these three, this test 2, test 3, and Databricks Azure. All of them are pointing to the resource, so to the same key vault. And as you see here, test 3, you can see here that you had the key that we just introduced in the key vault. Now you can point to that specific key, exactly the same that you do it with the Databricks secrets containers. You obviously don't see as well. This is blocked by the UI in the Databricks workspace. And basically that's all. As it's not probably not very interesting topic, but believe me, something that you need to know when you are building ML applications in Databricks or in Azure. This is something that you will have to work with. Is sometimes it's not the job is not always nice, not always very interesting, like working with prompting, with prompts, or fine tuning a model. Many times you just need to work with the environment and make it ready to your application work securely and integrated with the other components in the cloud. And this is, believe me, one of the things that you will be very thankful to know how it works, no? Especially if you have a role of machine learning engineer, this is one of the things that you will need to use, not only for Databricks, also especially in this case if you are working in Azure, for connecting your application, your ML application with DevOps, with Data Factory, with Azure ML, with the Data Lake, with whatever, Data Factory, Synapse, whatever you are using, other services in Azure AI services, whatever you need to access in Azure, you had all the secrets and access keys or URLs or URIs, which service principal accounts, whatever you need to access your services are always keep in key vaults, and you need to keep it secret, obviously, because there is the security of your companies rely on having these values in a safe place, and you need to know how to work this, how to use it, how to work in not only inside Databricks, all over the cloud. Okay, so in this case, that working in Azure. In other case, you can do the same in AWS, and similarly, some slightly more complicated when you work in Google Cloud, but also possible. The thing that you see here with DB utils and how to create secrets, this is working exactly the same regardless of the cloud provider. What the only thing that changes is the integration with the specific key vault provider in your cloud choice, no, in your cloud provider. In this case, we have Azure. We see how to integrate it with the vault. In other cases, there is a specific procedures to integrate it with the technologies the available on those providers. But the rest, the secrets stuff, the Databricks CLI, how you created the secrets, how you work inside the notebooks, this is exactly the same regardless if you are in Amazon, in Google, or in Azure. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you like it and it was useful for your job or your training. If that's the case, give me a like, subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before, and share with your friends and colleagues just to help me to promote the channel in YouTube. Thank you very much. See you soon.